Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So we are about to begin our celebration this morning. So if you haven't got a seat yet, please find a seat in the church, and then we will start in a couple of moments. Thank you. Still have a few more people coming through. So welcome everyone to our celebration this morning, the celebration of the perpetual profession of Chiu Nguyen and Daniel Markadia. And it's a joy for us to be here, to be with them, to pray with them, and to celebrate with them, and especially their families as well. Con xin kính chào quý cha, quý tu sĩ nam nữ, cùng toàn thể quý ông bà và anh chị em. Chào đón tất cả quý ông bà và anh chị em, chúng ta đến với thánh lễ vĩnh khấn của thầy Nguyễn Quốc Triệu và thầy Daniel Markadia ngày hôm nay. Just to begin, let us turn to the person next to you, especially those you don't know yet, and say hello as a way welcome. Thank you, everyone. So let us begin today by inviting Anne Marmion, the chairperson of the Parish Pastoral Council, to do the acknowledgement of country. Thank you.
We honour and acknowledge the Wurundjeri people of the Woiwurrung people of the Kulin Nation and as the traditional owners of the land on which we gather today, who have lived here in the Birrarung Valley, which we now call the Yarra, who have lived here in deep time for more than 30 times the Christian era, in harmony with the land, who have nurtured and been nurtured by this land. We acknowledge past wrongs and we pay our respects to their elders, past, present and emerging.
Let's stand to sing the entrance hymn.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our days. Blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of Flea, who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. Every moment of every day, our God is waiting to save. leaders seek the lost, they answer those who pray. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear family and friends of Daniel and Chu, dear brother missionaries of the Sacred Heart, fellow religious members of this parish community of St. Thomas's at Blackburn. It's a joy that we can gather together this morning as we celebrate with Chu and Daniel their profession of perpetual vows as missionaries of the Sacred Heart. Let's hold them in our prayers as we celebrate this Eucharist with them this morning. But let's pray for each other too, that we may each one of us be faithful to the life to which we have been called by Jesus, so that we can all of us be his witnesses in the world. As we enter into the Eucharist, let's turn humbly to the same Lord Jesus, opening our hearts once again to his mercy, that he might make us ready to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Take away the sins of the world, receive our
O God, who willed that the grace of baptism should flourish in these your servants, so that they might strive to follow more closely in the footsteps of your Son, grant, we pray, that constantly seeking evangelical perfection, they may add to the holiness of your Church and increase her apostolic zeal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Listen, Jacob, my servant, Israel, whom I have chosen. Thus says the Lord, who made you, who formed you in the womb, who is your help. Do not be afraid, Jacob, my servant, Jerusalem, whom I have chosen. For I shall pour out water on the thirsty soil, streams on the dry ground. I will pour out my spirit on your descendants, my blessing on your children. They shall grow like grass where there is plenty of water, like poplars by running streams. One person will say, I belong to the Lord. Another will call themselves by Jacob's name. On their hand, another will write, the Lord, and be surnamed Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Linh thương của Chúa Chúa đã phán, ta đã giao ước với người ta tuyến tròn. Đã thề cùng David tôi tớ ta rằng, dòng dõi người ta thiết lập cho đến ngàn đời. Ngài và người ta xây dựng qua muôn thế hệ.
Linh thương của Chúa con sẽ ca tụng hoài. Linh thương của Chúa sẽ muôn đời vững bền. Linh thương của Chúa chẳng bao giờ vội vãi. Linh thương của Chúa.
Và người đã thưa rằng, Ngài chính là thân phụ, là Thiên Chúa con thờ, núi đá tế độ con. Ta sẽ yêu thương người đến muôn thuở muôn đời, và thành tín giữ lời, giao ước với người.
Second reading. Pagbasa mula sa sulat ni Apostol San Pablo sa mga taga-Pilipos. Mga kapatid, inari kong kalugihan ang lahat ng bagay bilang kapalit na lalong mahalaga. Ang pagkakakilala kay Kristo Jesus na aking Panginoon. Ang lahat ng bagay ay ipinalagay kong walang kabuluhan. Makamtan ko lamang si Kristo at lubos na makiisa sa Kanya. Hindi ko nahangad na maging matuwid sa pamamagitan ng kautusan, kundi sa pananalig kay Kristo. Ang pagiging matuwid ko ngayon ay kaloob ng Diyos, batay sa pananampalataya. Ang tanging hangarin ko ngayon ay lubusang makilala si Kristo, maranasan ang kapangyarihan ng kanyang pagkabuhay na maguli, makihati sa kanyang mga hirap at matulad sa kanya, pati sa kanyang kamatayan, sa pag-asang ako may muling bubuhayin. Hindi sa nakamtan ko na ang mga bagay na ito, hindi rin sa ako'y ganap na, ngunit sinisikap kong maisakatuparan ang layunin ni Kristo Jesus nang tawagin niya ako. Mga kapatid, hindi ako ipinalalagay na natupad ko na ang mga bagay na ito. Ang ginagawa ko ngayon, nililimot ang nakaraan at sinisikap na makamtan ang nasa hinaharap. Nagpapatuloy nga ako tuno sa hangganang upang kamtan ang gantimpala ng pagkatawag sa akin ng Diyos sa pamamagitan ni Kristo Jesus, ang buhay na hahantong sa langit. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand to welcome the gospel.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. mysteries of your kingdom.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father. And no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy, and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Would those who are to profess their perpetual vows like to step forward? Daniel Magadia.
Present.
Chu Nguyen.
Present.
My dear brothers, what do you ask of God and of His Holy Church?
I ask for God's compassionate and merciful love and for the grace of serving God and God's people more intensely with the help of Mary, Our Lady of the Sacred Heart, and Saint Joseph, our protector, in the religious community of the missionaries of the Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Thanks be to God. On the eastern outskirts of Paris is a town named Laurency, and there stands a church dedicated, as is typical of French towns, to Notre Dame, to Our Lady of Laurency. It's a vast church. Up behind the original high altar, there are three chapels, the center one dedicated to the Sacred Heart. And there in the chapel is a statue of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. But it isn't a traditional statue of the Sacred Heart, with the extruded heart showing the piercing with a lance, the droplets of blood and water pouring forth, a flame at the top, all surrounded by a crown of thorns. Instead, this statue of the Sacred Heart is pure white and smooth, save for a finely etched heart, which is barely perceptible until we stand up close. I tried to photograph it, but without any success at all. This statue of the Sacred Heart is quite unlike any other I'd ever seen. Instead of the heart going out, as it were, signifying the outpouring of God's love and mercy through the human heart of Jesus, this statue of the Sacred Heart at Laurency appears to draw us in. signifying Jesus' invitation to come to him, to enter into his heart, and there to contemplate the love and compassion of God in the human heart of Jesus, to enter deeply into his heart, that we might come to know everything he chooses to reveal to us, which in truth is nothing less than the fullness of God. This being drawn into Christ Jesus, not just drawn to him, but drawn into contemplation of his heart, True and Daniel, is at the very centre of our vocation as missionaries of the Sacred Heart. It's this closeness, this intimacy with Jesus, this communion of our hearts with his heart, his gentle and humble heart, which makes it possible for us to discover in our own hearts the depths of God's love for us, a love which is greater than we could ever ask or imagine. It's our response to this same experience of God's love which compels us to mission, to share with others all that we have received from Jesus, all that we have come to know of the Father's love for us, which took flesh in the heart of Jesus. St. Paul recognizes this, I think, in his own life, setting forth in that second reading we heard from his letter to the Philippians, the supreme advantage, as he calls it, of knowing Christ Jesus, of forsaking everything else in life, so as to have life in him through the power of his dying and rising. That is, through what we call the Paschal Mystery. It's through baptism that we all enter into the mystery of Jesus' death and resurrection. It's through baptism that it becomes possible for us to make the pattern of Jesus dying and rising the pattern of our own human Christian living. And of course, it's through our participation in the Eucharist that our life in Christ Jesus is nourished and strengthened and sustained. Here this morning, Daniel and True, you will affirm through perpetual vows a choice you've already made and committed to, a choice like that of St. Paul, to accept loss of everything so that you can have a place in Christ Jesus and be given a place in him. That by embracing his dying and rising as the pattern of your own lives, you can pursue for the rest of your days and years what you have already come to know through him, which is nothing less than the love of God for you, and a glimpse of the totality of that love, which is the fullness of God. The vows you profess in a few minutes are a radical way, to use St. Paul's imagery, of capturing the prize for which Christ Jesus has captured you. Of the many disciples of Jesus who were called to follow him and to learn from him, relatively few are chosen to live consecrated life. By professing poverty, you are freely letting go of possessing the things of this world that might otherwise possess you. By professing consecrated chastity, you are freely letting go of the fullest expression of our human sexuality, that you might have ever deeper intimacy with Jesus and live out of that love with which he has first loved you. And by professing obedience in fraternal charity, you are letting go of fulfilling your own will, so that by attentive listening and discernment, the will of Jesus for you can become your own will. What you profess here this morning in our midst is truly graced by God. You can be sure of that. For those of us who've been on this journey for many years already, your profession today gives us new heart. For those just beginning, or perhaps discerning this way of life, your profession serves to inspire. And yet what you are professing here today, what you're committing to for the whole of your lives, is not always easy. Patterning your lives on the dying and rising of Jesus means accepting even death, so that we die to ourselves over and again, that we might share ever more fully in his life, the life which flows from the heart of Jesus, pierced on the cross, that life which comes to us through the gift of his Spirit, poured out upon our church to bring salvation to all people. So, Chu and Daniel, here in the presence of your families, of your friends, of your brother missionaries of the Sacred Heart, come forward and entrust yourselves to the heart of Jesus, that you may come to know in your own journeys ever more deeply the fullness of his love for you, and strive to live wholeheartedly for him. Commit yourselves to him in the little society of the missionaries of the Sacred Heart by professing perpetual vows, that you might share fully in the life and mission towards to which he has called you and for which you've been chosen. And make your own in our common life and mission the motto given to us and handed down from our founder, Jules Chevalier: may the Sacred Heart of Jesus be loved everywhere.
Brothers, in baptism you have already died to sin and been consecrated to God's service. Believing in the love God has shown us in the heart of Christ, are you now resolved to unite yourselves more closely to God by the bond of perpetual profession as missionaries of the Sacred Heart of Jesus?
I am.
Are you resolved, with the help of God,
to undertake that life of consecrated celibacy, obedience in fraternal charity, and evangelical poverty, so as to follow Jesus with all your hearts and to persevere in this life forever?
I am.
Are you resolved to strive steadfastly for perfection in the love of God and of your neighbour by making the heart of Jesus loved everywhere in all you say and do, and keeping the rule of our religious community.
I am.
Are you resolved with the help of the Holy Spirit to spend your whole life in generous service of God's people?
I am.
May God, who has begun this good work in you, bring it to fulfillment before the day of Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Dear friends in Christ, let us pray to God the Almighty Father for these servants of his whom he has called to follow Christ in the religious life. In his love, may he bless them with his grace and strengthen them with his holy purpose.
Please kneel.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Angels of God,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
And Saint John, of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Lauren,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua, Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
And Saint Agnes,
pray for us.
And Saint Monica,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine, Saint Francis,
pray for us.
And Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Philip Neri,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for us.
And Saint John Vianney, Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
All you holy men and women,
pray for us.
Saint Therese Lovius the
Earth, pray for us.
And Saint Thomas,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony of Padua,
pray for us.
Saint Vincent Ferrer,
pray for us.
Saint Mary of the Cross,
pray for us.
Pope Saint John,
pray for us.
Blessed Martyrs of Spain,
pray for us.
Blessed Peter Torot,
all you hold.
from all evil,
save your people
from every sin,
save your people
from everlasting death,
save your people
by your incarnation,
save your people
and by your death and resurrection,
save your people
and by your gift of the Spirit,
save your people.
Have mercy on us sinners.
Christ, hear us, Lord. Jesus, hear our prayer.
Lord, give new life.
Hear our prayer.
To his chosen.
Hear our prayer.
By the grace of consecration,
hear our prayer.
O Jesus, Son of the living God,
hear our prayer.
Send your Spirit,
hear our prayer.
In its fullness,
hear our prayer.
On these chosen ones,
hear our prayer.
Who believe and profess you,
hear our prayer.
Christ, hear us, Lord. Jesus, hear our prayer.
Lord, grant these prayers of your people. Prepare the hearts of your servants for their consecration to your service. By the grace of the Holy Spirit, purify them from all sin and set them on fire with your love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
I now invite the witnesses to come forward, please.
Lord Jesus Christ, trusting in the boundless mercy of your Sacred Heart and called through the gift of your Spirit to follow and serve you so that the world may come to know your love for the Father and for all, and so that your kingdom may come. I, Daniel Magadia, vow for the rest of my life obedience in fraternal charity, consecrated celibacy, and evangelical poverty in the Society of the Missionaries of the Sacred Heart, according to its constitutions. I make these vows before you, Father Stephen Hackett, the delegate of the Superior General, and in the presence of my confreres gathered here. Lord Jesus Christ, help me to be faithful through the grace of your Holy Spirit, the intercession of Our Lady of the Sacred Heart, and of Saint Joseph, our protector.
Lord Jesus Christ, trusting in the boundless mercy of your Sacred Heart and called, through the gift of your Spirit, to follow and to serve you, so that the world may come to know your love for the Father and for all, and so that your kingdom may come, I, Quoc Chiu Nguyen, vow for the rest of my life, obedience in fraternal charity, consecrated celibacy, and eventually go poverty in the society of missionaries of the Sacred Heart, according to its constitutions. I make these vows before you, Father Stephen Hackett, the delegate of Superior General, in the presence of my confreres gathered here. Lord Jesus Christ, help me to be faithful through the grace of your Holy Spirit, the intercession of Our Lady of the Sacred Heart, and of Saint Joseph, our protector. Amen.
Father in heaven, source of all holiness, creator of the human race, your love for us was so great that you gave us a share in your own divine life. Neither the sin of Adam, nor even the sins of the whole world, could alter your loving purpose. In the dawn of history, you gave us Abel as an example of holiness. Later, from your beloved Hebrew people, you raised up men and women graced with every virtue. Foremost among them stands Mary, the ever-virgin daughter of Zion. From her pure womb was born Jesus Christ, your eternal Word, the Saviour of the world. You sent him, Father, as our pattern of holiness. He became poor to make us rich, a slave to set us free. With love no words can tell, he redeemed the world by his paschal mystery and won from you the gifts of the Spirit to sanctify his church. The voice of the Spirit has drawn countless numbers of your children to follow in the footsteps of your Son. They leave all things to be one with you in the bonds of love and give themselves wholly to your service and the service of all your people. Look with favour, then, on these who have heard your call. Send the Spirit of holiness. Help them to fulfil in faith what you have enabled them to promise in joy. Keep always before their eyes Christ, the divine teacher. May they build up the church by the holiness of their lives, advance the salvation of the world, and stand as a sign of the blessings that are to come. Lord, protect and guide these servants of yours. At the judgment seat of your Son, be yourself their great reward. Give them the joy of vows fulfilled. Made perfect in your love, may they rejoice in the communion of your saints and praise you forever in their company. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now Daniel and Chiu, together with their witnesses and the provincial superior, will cite the formulas of the vows and the profession book.
True, and Daniel, we confirm that each of you is now fully one with us as members of this religious community of the missionaries of the Sacred Heart, sharing all things in common with us now and in the future. Be faithful to the ministry the Church entrusts to you to be carried out in its name. Amen.
I also now invite all the MSCs to come forward to give Chu and Daniel a sign of peace and as a sign of welcome as full members of the Missionary of the Sacred Heart. Please come forward. Stand for the prayers of the faithful.
Trusting in the Father's great love for us, revealed in the Sacred Heart of Jesus, we turn to Him with our prayers.
Para sa simbahan, naway ipagpatuloy nila maging sa mundo iyong puso sa kanilang pagpapahayag ng mabuting balita at sa kanilang pangangalaga sa kapwa at sa kalikasan. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Cầu cho Đức Thánh Cha Francisco và các vị lãnh đạo trong giáo hội, xin cho các ngài biết chuyên chăm lắng nghe tiếng Chúa Thánh Thần để có thể hướng dẫn giáo hội trên con đường hiệp hành, con đường của sự lắng nghe và bước đi cùng nhau trong tình yêu và hy vọng. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our world, that we may be heralds of unity, justice, compassion, and peace, may we discover the face of Christ in our brothers and sisters who are poor and marginalized. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families of the professed and the friends and benefactors of the MSCs, that their support, encouragement, and generosity may bear fruit in our mission. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the members of the Chevalier family, that they may be inspired and driven by your love as they strive to make your heart known and loved everywhere. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those discerning their vocation in life, that they may be guided by the Spirit as they discover in their hearts your call. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people suffering from sickness or hardship, that they may be comforted and supported by those around them. We also commend those who have gone before us. We pray especially for the deceased loved ones of Daniel and Tree. May they experience your loving embrace in the heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, you have called us each by name and invited us to share in the service of your people. Hear our prayers and those that are unspoken in our hearts. By your strength, may we continue to serve you and to be ever renewed by your Spirit. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. accept the sacrifice from your hands, the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
Receive the gifts of intentions of your servants, O Lord, and confirm in your love those who profess the evangelical counsels, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. He is the unblemished flower who sprang from the root of the Virgin and declared the pure of heart blessed, teaching by his way of life the unsurpassing worth of chastity. He chose always to hold fast to what is pleasing to you, and becoming obedient for our sake even until death, he willingly offered himself to you as a perfect and fragrant sacrifice. He consecrated to a fuller service of your majesty those who, for love of you, leave earthly things and promised they would find treasure in heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Oh, Hosanna, oh, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice.
Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world.
Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Strengthen in their holy resolve, O Lord, these your servants who today have bound themselves to you perpetually in the sacred bonds of religious profession, and grant that they may show forth in your church the new and eternal life purchased for us by Christ's redemption.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by the Word of God, we dare to say.
You are our Father, you live in heaven, we talk to you, Father, you are good. You are our Father, you live in heaven, we talk to you, Father, you are good. We believe your word, Father, we, your children, give us bread today. We believe your word, Father, we, your children, give us bread today. We have done wrong, we are sorry, help us, Father, not to sin again. We have done wrong, we are sorry, help us, Father, not to sin again. Others have done wrong to us, and we are sorry for them, Father, today. Others have done wrong to us, and we are sorry for them, Father, today. Stop us from doing wrong, Father, save us all from the evil one. Stop us from doing wrong, Father, save us all from the evil one. You are our Father, you live in heaven, we talk.
talk to you, Father, you are good. You are a Father, you live in heaven. We talk to you, Father, you are good.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Well, peace be with you. Thank you. Thank you. Peace be with you, Alan. Thank you. Peace be with you, Mark. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Peace be with you, Corey. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Having received with reverence the divine mysteries, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, to inflame with the fire of the Holy Spirit these your servants, bound to you now by an act of sacred offering, and to admit them forever to the company of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, too.
I'm so sorry, I have 5 pages today. I would like to borrow one of our brothers, Frank Anderson's songs, to express my attitude today. Now, I thank my God each time I think of you. And when I pray for you, I pray with joy. Yeah, this is such a joyful and precious moment for our lives. Not because we make the perpetual commitment to God in the society of the missionaries of the Sacred Heart, but also through this occasion, we really feel the prayers, support, and help of many people, and we are really deeply thankful for that. First of all, I would like to thank the provincial, Stephen Hackett, for receiving our profession on behalf of Superior General, and also for your supportive guides in order to prepare for the liturgical part of this occasion. Personally, I thank you for your help and effort in the process of getting visas for my family and friends so that they are able to be here today with me. Thank you for your confidence in me. Thank you, the province in general, our brother embassies present here, Victoria and Tasmania embassy community, embassies in Blackburn area, especially those who, in their kindness, Peter Hendrick and Mary Catherine arranged accommodations, faculties, and welcomed my family and friends during their time in Australia. Thank you. I would like to thank people I have privilege to meet in the journey with information. Chris McPhee, Frank Lenin, who else? Mark Hans, Coy, Peter Harvey Jackson, our lecturers in YTU, teachers in USPM, visiting speakers, spiritual directors, and pastoral supervisors. Thank you, Jeff, my dear friend, who introduced me to the embassies and support me a lot in many ways so that I am able to be here today. I would like to express my gratitude to those who contribute their efforts to make this day happen joyfully and nicely. Thank you, Arlo, the parish priest of this parish, Susan, parish council, catering team, owner parishioners in St. Thomas. Thank you, liturgical team, Coy, the MC here today, Tuan, the deacon, Ty, Jacob, Sebastian, the choirs. We have St. Thomas Choir with the help of Chris Monahan, the president of YTU. Thank you. The Holy Family Choir from St. Joseph Parish, Springvale. Krishna, Gusti, Teresa, and Indonesian Choir. Social media and communication team, Mr. Wu and his friends, Mr. Lok, Mr. Jung. Thank you, the cooking team, St. Timothy Vietnamese community, Indonesian community, and St. Thomas Parish, and those who bring their place today, even though it's not a compulsory. And those who are behind the scene help us in many ways, not only today, but throughout our journey. So let us give them a big applause. I cannot forget to mention all the people gathered here today, our families, our friends, priests, religious brothers and sisters. The light from YTU, USPM, pastoral placement, and from other states of Australia and from overseas. Thank you for being here with us. Thank you, Daniel, my brother, and your and your family, Mom Mary and David. I still remember on our first profession, you told me, now I am your mother too. Thank you. Con xin cảm ơn quý cha, quý tu sĩ nam nữ đến từ giáo phận Phú Cường, Bình Dương, Việt Nam,
và quý cha, quý tu sĩ nam nữ trong đại gia đình liên tu sĩ linh mục Việt Nam tại tiểu bang Victoria. Dì Sương, dòng Minh Thánh Giá Triệu Quán, cha Tính đến từ cộng đoàn MC Việt Nam đã dành thời gian hiện diện và cầu nguyện cho con. Cách riêng các anh chị em đã giúp con trong việc tổ chức và chuẩn bị cho thánh lễ này. Con quên không có nói đến những người cắm hoa đây nữa, có Sơ Quỳnh Anh, có thầy Cường và thầy Thắng dòng Bassinis nữa. Cảm ơn bé Linh đã hỗ trợ cho nhà dòng trong việc thiết kế đồ họa. Cảm ơn gia đình thánh ca đoàn Thánh Gia một lần nữa. Chị Duyên, anh Quân, anh Hiệp đã nhận lời giúp nhà dòng trong thánh lễ hôm nay. Con cảm ơn cộng đoàn St. Timothy đã giúp nhà dòng trong việc chuẩn bị bữa ăn. Một số gia đình còn quảng đại hỗ trợ nơi lưu trú cho gia đình con và khách mời của con từ xa tới. Đây cũng là nơi thân thương mà anh em con có cơ hội đến đây thực tập phục vụ. Và con cũng nhớ tới và cầu nguyện cho những người trong cộng đoàn đã qua đời, cô Đào và anh Nghị. Những người đã thân thương đón tiếp con khi con mới chập chững bước chân đến nước Úc này. Con cảm ơn bạn bè thân hữu, những tương quan xa gần, đại gần đã hiện diện với con trong ngày trọng đại này. Và cả những người không thể tham dự khách thể lý nhưng đang hiện diện với con trên livestream cũng như là trong lời cầu nguyện. Con cảm ơn anh em trong nhà dòng, những người đang cùng con bước đi trong linh đạo trái tim trong dòng từ sai thánh tâm. Mark là cha giáo của con, Khôi là MC hôm nay cha Khôi, Phong, Hòa, Nang, Long đã giúp em và Daniel rất nhiều trong việc chuẩn bị những ngày vừa qua và tổ chức thánh lễ cũng như đón tiếp gia đình của chúng em. Con xin lỗi không thể kể hết được mọi người, những ân nhân, những thân hữu của nhà dòng, của anh em chúng con, những người đã và vẫn đang âm thầm hỗ trợ và góp phần vun trồng những ân gọi, những mầm non thừa sai thánh tâm. Con xin tri ân hết tất cả mọi người. Và con cũng, giờ đây con cũng muốn cảm ơn gia đình, cảm ơn bà nội, cảm ơn ba má, gia đình bác Trúc Dũng, dì Úc, cảm ơn các anh chị em đến từ Sydney và Brisbane đã... Đây là lần đầu tiên khi con bước vào dòng, anh gia đình con có thể hiện diện ở đây cách khá là đầy đủ nhất trong ngày trọng đại này. Con biết là giờ đây có nói lời gì đi chăng nữa cũng không có đủ và đầy những gì gia đình đã làm cho con. Con chỉ biết cúi đầu con xin cảm ơn gia đình rất nhiều vậy. I'm sorry if there are someone that I miss to mention, but surely you are all in our prayers and talks. Thank you, con xin hết lòng tri ân.
What else can I add from that? I remember 4.5 years ago, I first met Chu, and it's really the night and day almost, and now I answer to Chu. I'll try my best to cover everything, and maybe there's a bit of repetition, especially as we approach the real highlight of the day, lunch. In a recent trip to New Zealand, I think it was about 1.5 months ago, our formator, Mark, went bungee jumping for the first time. And we thought, how could we match that without the risk of physical injury? I guess it was taking final vows. As I was speaking earlier, the formula, I think I was at that edge of that bridge, and I thought, the only way now is to dive. And so we dove. Chu and I made similar speeches during our first profession 3 years ago. I remember saying that reflecting on my formation journey so far reinforced my belief in providence and how God has been working in my life and Chu's life as well. Fast forward to the present, I still feel it to be right. I again realized how privileged I was for this time as an MSc student, where we, Chu and I, matured so much and learned a lot. Chu and I will forever cherish our time at both Douglas Park and, of course, here at Blackburn. And a word of thanks to the parish who have been our supporters since day one. This brings me to our families here, who were our first formators. It was through them that we learned the Christian faith. And many of them are present here from far and wide, and many others are watching right now on the live stream. That we thank you. As mentioned by Chu, we encounter the MSC in different stages of our lives. Chu once described meeting the MSC, as he said through Jeff, to be a miracle. Is that right? It's a miracle. And to some extent in my life, it is true as well. I was introduced to them as a migrant teenager in Adelaide. I am sure many will agree to this who are present here, that once you are bitten by the MSC bug, there's pretty much no turning back, and you are never the same. A few of which are now, who are my heroes, are in heaven right now. Then in 2019, we both joined the congregation. Here we thank our formators through the years, from Koi to Peter, and of course, more recently, Mark. We also thank those who have formed us educationally, especially at YTU. A brief mention as well to our spiritual directors who have been us through the years too. A special mention from my end to Julie Adam and Kevin Hennessy, who led us in our retreat a few months ago. Again, because I'm sure many of us are starving, I might as well end from here. So I thank you for all who are gathered here, in person and online, for you have made this celebration really special. Thank you.
Thank you, Chu and Daniel. I know that you're all hungry, so I'll be quick. Just a couple of practical announcements. Lunch will be served in the school hall, just across the car park there. If you walk out and just go in that direction, you reach the hall. If not, you can follow the others. We won't be lost. And when we get there, we will wait for everyone to, well, most of us will be there, and then we say grace, and then we start our lunch together. But before that, you can get a drink or something to start off with. There are some MSC vocation promotions products out there in the foyer, in the narthex of the church. So feel free to take them and spread the good news of the MSCs. Hopefully you get more vocations. And they are free, because vocations are free gifts of God. Photo taking. After the final blessings, while the choir is singing the recessional hymn, Chu and Daniel and their families, together with Father Stephen Hackett and all the concelebrating priests, will be standing in front of the sanctuary here to take a photo. And then after that, we will process out of the church. So thank you very much.
Can I add just two words of thanks to the many words of thanks which have already been spoken? The first is to all of you for your love and care and support of these two brothers of mine who've made their perpetual profession here today. Their journeys continue. They'll still need your love and care and support. But thank you for all the ways in which you've shown them that love and care and support over their journeys to this time. Please continue to support them with your prayers and in so many other ways as they move into the future. And of course, we thank God who's been at work in their lives. As they've discerned their vocations to be missionaries of the Sacred Heart and to share fully in our life and mission. So ever before us is what God is doing. We can often be very, very aware of what we're doing and
we know it makes a difference, and that's important. But God works in all sorts of ways, through us and in their hearts, through all those who've in different ways touched their lives. So we do thank God for God's work in their lives these past years. If you'd stand for the blessing, please. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
May God, the inspirer of every good resolve, foster your purposes and strengthen your hearts, that what you have promised you may keep with persevering faith.
Amen.
May he grant you to hasten in the joy of Christ along the narrow way you have chosen, rejoicing to bear the burdens of your sisters and brothers.
Amen.
May the charity of God make of you a family brought together in the Lord's name to show forth the image of the love of Christ.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here for these sacred mysteries, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Pilgrim people of many tribes and tongues, scattered far in a wide and thirsty land. We gather to remember, to be nourished by your song. We come to touch a living heart in whom we all in your spirit, anoint us in your love, and lead us on to living water, fulfill your plans for us, strengthen us together to proclaim your loving word, renew us. The ones who walked beside us through the years. May their faith inspire courage. May we hear the call they heard. Awakening our lives today, the power of your word. Renew us in your spirit. Anoint us in your love and lead us on to living water, fulfill your plans for us.